What you need, girl?
I need a hot boy.
6 foot with 6 figures and a big toy. Heard he moving weight down south to Chicago, Illinois. And he need a college girl who will cancel why I'm poor.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome to the crew. And if you're back, mess with you. Also, happy holidays, guys. I'm so excited that Christmas is right around the corner. It's my first, like, Christmas on YouTube. And, you know, I was gonna do Vlogmas, but I was like, I'm gonna let him down, like, real hard, you know? So, hopefully next year, you know, when I get the hang of things a little bit more, Vlogmas will be an option. But this year, like, I already know, I was like, pause. You know, I don't want to start something that I know I can't finish. Especially with finals around the corner, y'all. Your girl has been going a little crazy. Like, I haven't even had a minute to really think about, like, what I want for Christmas, what I'm going to get other people for Christmas. So you already know I'm going to have to level up, you know, get with the program, because Christmas is, like, the best time of year. And I'm so excited. I want to do so many, like, cute, fun things. But I'm rambling. The point of this video is to help y'all out, okay? Christmas gifts, Christmas shopping is so hard, especially when, like, all you see are things for yourself. Okay, that sounds wrong, but I'm so right. I shop best for myself, you know? But whenever I try to find gifts for other people, like, I'm always like, are they gonna appreciate it? Do they even like this? Like, you know, especially people who, like, you ask what they want, they're like, nothing really, or don't worry about it, or I trust you. Like, no, you don't want to trust me, because I will get you a macaroni necklace. I will. So in this video, I'm going to give you guys, hold on, I have my list right here, 7 thoughtful gifts. And these aren't just your, you know, average regular gift, you know, some clothes, perfume, Pandora charm necklace, whatever. No, this is like, wow, you took your time to plan that out for me. It's one of those gifts. So just bear with me while I go through these 7 gifts. And hopefully, if you guys, you know, decide that you like a few, maybe 1 or 2, comment down below. Wait, oh my God, I cannot be crooked. I was crooked. Make sure that you guys comment down below if you guys do try out any of these presents, and, you know, what were their reactions, you know, so come back after Christmas and just watch this video again. All right, y'all, you already know my little list, very professional. Number 1 is to burn a CD of your favorite songs together. So basically, it could be all of their favorite songs, or if you guys kind of have, like, the same music taste, or you just want to, like, introduce them to some new music. I thought this was super cute, and I understand that, like, not a lot of people use CDs, so that is the point of this thoughtful gift. It's something physical, it's something that you have to take your time out to do, make a little mixtape, a little playlist, and it's just, ugh, if anyone made this for me, I would cry. But yeah, of course, if you don't want to do the CD, the alternative would be a playlist, maybe on Apple Music, Spotify, Tidal, whatever your platform is, even SoundCloud. I just thought it would be more personal to do a CD. You could do this for your significant other, your little sister. I actually got this idea because my big sister actually used to do this for me almost every month, but that was like a few years ago, and it took a lot of time, so I was really thankful. And she has the best music taste, like, ever. Shout out to Ashley. It's just so cute. Like, what? Who does that? We do that. Okay. Next. Gift number 2 is to go to Build-A-Bear together and get a child. Or just a bear, you know, you don't have to be boyfriend or girlfriend, whatever. So listen. You don't have to go to Build-A-Bear with them. I mean, the experience would be super cute overall, but it kind of ruins the surprise effect. So you can actually, like, go to Build-A-Bear and, like, and do it by yourself, and, you know, all the birth certificate and stuff. But I just thought the experience would be cute. I actually did this with my friend Kennedy last year. It wasn't for Christmas or anything, but yes, I do have a son. Hold on, let me get that. This is my son, Benny, with an I at the end. He has a heartbeat. He's so cute, and I'm really happy that we did this because, you know, it's just something to, like, make sure that you see your friends. If you do, like, decide to share the bear, you know, just, like, always kind of like handing it off or whatever, or if you just want to give it to someone for them to keep. It really doesn't matter, and it doesn't have to be with your boyfriend or girlfriend or whatever. It can literally just be with like one of your really good friends or like a sibling. I just thought the idea was super cute, like picking out the name and the clothes, and yeah. Gift number three is concert tickets to your favorite artist. This is expensive. So if you're a baller, you know, a shot caller, I really, really recommend this. Yeah, who doesn't want to go to a concert with their favorite artist? I just think it'd be like a really cool experience. You can get two or even three, like if you have a group of friends or, you know, like I said, siblings or your mom or dad, like whatever. Yeah, and then you guys can go together, because these thoughtful gifts, I think they lead more to experiences, like the CD you can listen to the car on long car rides with them, the Build-A-Bear, again, like you can like switch off, and just something to remind you of them, and then the concert, of course, that's a whole experience. I'm gonna like go out to eat before, after, you know, just like the Snapchat videos, crazy, the music. But yeah, so you can get concert tickets for them. And you know, if you are like me and you do not have the funds this year, you could actually get them a record. And not a lot of people have a record player. You don't have to invest in that, but I feel like the thought is what counts. It's like a piece of art, especially if they have one specific album. I did this last year with my brother Gabe, and he said that one of his favorite albums was J. Cole's 2014 Forest Hills Drive. So I thought it'd be really cool to, like, you know, make him realize that I do notice the little things, like whenever we talk or just hang out. So I actually got him a record from Urban Outfitters, I think. Or there's a record store by my house too. I forgot which one I got it from. But yeah, and I made him a nice card and I wrote some song lyrics on there. And it's just really thoughtful. Again, you don't have to spend so much money like a concert to really express your love. Gift number four, which is like one of my personal faves, is also a little bit pricey, by the way, but it's just to customize their shoes for them. So me, I've always wanted this or wanted to do this. I haven't gotten the chance yet, but you see like a lot of like Converse, Vans, or Air Force Ones, and a lot of people have been like drawing on them, or sometimes they like embroider them with the Vans, I know, because they're like cloth shoes or like fabric shoes or something like that, you know. And I just thought it'd be like a really cool collectible, like it's something one of a kind that you took your time out to make, craft, and it could just be like some of their favorite things on there. It could be like an inside joke even. It doesn't have to be like amazing, like you don't have to be Picasso to do this, and it shows your effort and how you were thinking of them, because you can put like, you know, maybe if they really like butterflies, you could put a butterfly on it. If they have like this quote, you could put like a little quote on it, or their initials. There's just so many like personal touches that you can add to such a plain shoe. And if it's their favorite shoe, then like bonus points. Gift number five is nothing tangible, but it takes a lot of work.
They tell me I should fix my grill, cause I got money now. I ain't gon' sit around in front like I ain't thought about it. A perfect smile is more appealing, but it's funny how my shit is crooked, look at how far I done got without it. I keep my twisted grill just to show the kids it's real. We ain't picture perfect, but we worth the picture still.
$20?
I got smart, I got rich, and I got picture still. And they all look like my eyebrows, thick as hell. Love yourself, girl, or nobody will. Though you a woman, I don't know how you deal with all the pressure to look impressive and go out in heels. I feel for you, killing yourself to find a man that'll kill for you. You wake up, put makeup on, stare in the mirror, but it's clear that you can't face what's wrong. No need to fix what God already put his paintbrush on. Your roommate yelling, why you gotta take so long? What it's like to have a...
I've been seeing this on Twitter and Instagram a lot, but it's like a video montage of all your memories together, and I thought that was so cute. I always see them with boyfriend and girlfriend. I always say that, like I sound so lame. I guess like your significant other, but Yeah, you can do this with your friend. You can do this with your mom. Just put some like music in the background. Just kind of like something like sentimental. And then you can use iMovie to like put all your pictures and videos together. And you know, watch a few editing videos on YouTube. That's literally what I did. And you know, just put the video together. And I wouldn't just send it to them on iMessage on Christmas. Maybe you could like hook it up to the TV with the HDMI cord, or just kind of like present it in front of your family, or you know, wherever you are. I think that'd be really thoughtful. Number 6 is kind of the alternative to the video. If you want something tangible, you can actually get like a cork board, or you make a collage. Something where you can like hang pictures on and make a picture board of y'all. That's also super cute. And it does take a little bit more work because everything is kind of like pinning and gluing or like clipping and then buying the whole frame. But I definitely think it's worth it. They can hang it on their walls. You can even make a matching one for yourself. But I just think that that's really cute too. Number 7 and my final thoughtful gift idea. Hold on, I forgot to put my glasses on for this. Like I cannot read, y'all. To write a meaningful, write them a meaningful letter about the first time you met or a memory. So I did this, not for Christmas, but actually for my brother's birthday. It was his 18th birthday, and I wrote him maybe like a 2 or 3 page letter. And again, if you're not a writer, you don't have to do this, but you know, I've been blessed. I really, really think that it was a good idea because it kind of allowed me to tell him some things that I didn't know how to communicate in person, because I mean I do love to write, and that's kind of like one of my things, my talents. Then I just wrote about like why I look up to him and just kind of shared some things that I never told him before, like you know, memories when we were little. So you can kind of do something like that, especially if it's a family member. And you know, if it's a friend, or like I said,
a boyfriend or girlfriend,
you can do how you guys first met and like what you were thinking and your first impressions, like if you were nervous or anything, and just make it super sweet, because sometimes people don't always know like what you're thinking, or like it's kind of like how one thing happens to y'all and y'all see it in two different perspectives. You can write on your perspective. That's it for this super quick video, y'all. I just wanted to share some thoughtful gift ideas that are just, you know, they go the extra mile because the crew does the most, period.